Regular meeting number 53 will now come to order. Please stand for the playing of the national anthem.
Thank you, and it's an honor to be here. And let me just say real quickly, it's so neat to see Jiza and Shannon. They're like my children, and she went to school with my daughter at Columbus School for Girls. Okay, that's my mother thing. All right, I'm done. Shall we pray? Almighty God, you who are the God of us all, you who woke us up this morning, you who put inside each one of us a purpose, a reason for us being here, I ask you on this day to come by and be in this place and to lay your presence on these lawmakers. You have given them a specific call. It's not an easy call. You have given them the responsibility to serve all people, no matter their color, their race, their ethnicity, their religion. You have charged them, God, to have eyes that see and ears that hear and hearts that feel, and then the capacity to do what the people need. So wrap your arms around them, God, and let them feel your presence, but then convict them of your presence every single day, and let them feel your presence as they work on behalf of the people. It is your gift to them to be able to serve. Let them, Lord God, give that gift right back to you. And I ask it in the name of the God of us all, Protestant and Catholic and religious and Muslims and Jewish and all of God's people, and let the people of God say amen.
Dr. Smith, thank you for being here, and thank you for your willingness to help start us and off on the right foot and lead us in prayer. Thank you for being here. Clerk, call the roll.
Hardin, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
Thank you. Can I get a motion to dispense with the reading of the journal? Is there a second? Clerk, call the roll.
Hardin, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
Thank you. This week's communications received by the City Clerk's office are listed on the agenda and will be published in the City Bulletin. Are there any other communications to be read into the record?
Not at this time.
Any announcements or resolutions from members of Council? Councilmember Hardin?
Thank you, President Ginther. Tonight I bring Resolution 268X-2015 to express the City of Columbus's commitment as a place of refuge for those fleeing violence in Syria. The country of Syria is currently engulfed in a conflict that has displaced 7 million people. 4 million of those people have left their country, and that total rises every day. President Barack Obama has committed the United States to accepting 10,000 Syrian refugees over the next couple of years, 0.25% of all Syrian refugees. There has been rhetoric put out that the United States cannot accept these 10,000 children, women, and men in that order. There has been rhetoric that we should not accept 10,000 orphans, widows, and families. This council brings this resolution to signal to the world that Columbus has a tradition and custom of welcoming refugees and immigrants, and that this city will not shy away from those principles that make us truly America's Opportunity City. While this is merely a resolution of expression, words on a piece of paper, it is about so much more. It is about kindness, it is about openness, it is about generosity, and it's about humanity and empathy. While this is symbolic, people give power and take power from symbols. The Statue of Liberty is a symbol of all the promises and opportunities of America. It is a symbol of hope to countless immigrants and refugees coming from places far and wide, from different circumstances. Matthew 25:35 tells us, "For I was hungry, and you gave me something to eat. I was thirsty, and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger, and you invited me in." I hope those 10,000 refugees coming to the United States know that in Columbus, the inn is not full. Our hearts, our minds, and our arms are open to you. I would like to thank all of my colleagues on council for co-sponsoring this resolution and for their support. With that, I would like to bring up Director Bale, who has additional comments.
Thank you so much, Chair Hardin, President Ginther, and also with me, with the our New Americans Coordinator and my Assistant Director, Guadalupe Velasquez. You know, and I thank you so much for your words, Councilmember Hardin, because as MLK, the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King stated, our lives begin the day, to end the day, we become silent about things that matter, and truly understand that this matters. Also, I'd like to read a quick quote, and then Guadalupe will then begin on where we are going to go from here. This quote by the UN High Commissioner Paul Hartling. He stated, "There are many challenges facing the international community today, but few in mind are more pressing than those of finding humanitarian solutions to refugee problems. We talk of regional conflicts, of economic and social crisis, of political instability, of abuses of human rights, of racism, religious intolerance, inequalities between rich and poor, hunger, overpopulation, underdevelopment, and I could go on and on. Each and every one of these impediments to humanity's pursuit of well-being are also among the root causes of refugee problems."
Good evening, President Ginther, Chair Shannon Hardin, and council members. Our office is working with national organizations such as Welcoming America, the White House Office of New Americans, and regional networks such as We Global Network to address the fear-based rhetoric that has arisen from the tragic attack in Paris and other European countries in recent time. The City of Columbus Refugee Resettlement Organizations, Us Together, CRIS, and World Relief are working together with CRC and the New Americans Initiative to host multiple events in education to educate the community on refugee resettlement process. This is very important because it's important for everyone to know it takes exactly 2 years for the process of someone to enter into the United States. Beginning with the release of the full report, I have a sample here for you of the refugees and the positive impact of refugees in Central Ohio, which we collaborated with the Department of Development on. This is to identify the positive social, cultural, and economic impact that refugees contribute to Central Ohio. If I could just comment that, so for instance, $35.9 million refugee household spending in Central Ohio, 13.6% of refugees own small businesses in Central Ohio. Beginning with this report, on December 5th, World Relief Columbus will be hosting an information session at Vineyard Columbus from 1:30 to 3 p.m. to discuss the refugee resettlement process and answer questions that are related to refugee resettlement in Columbus. December 8th, CRC will be hosting a lunch and learn to discuss diversity in faith, immigrant, and refugee crisis. This forum will be from 11:30 a.m. to 1:30 at the Jerry Hammond Center. December 9th, Us Together will be hosting a refugee panel discussion from 6 to 8 p.m. at Global Gallery. Additionally, we are working with six major cities in Ohio that we're called the Ohio Welcoming Initiative. We're working on creating a letter that will ask political, corporate, and community faith-based leaders to sign this letter in support of who we are as Ohioans. And who we are is we are compassionate people that have strong values in inclusivity. And one quote that was said on a call with the White House, the cornerstone of this country breeds values, not fear. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Director and Guadalupe Velasquez. Thank you. I would also like to thank the support and the hard work and leadership of Councilmember Paley, Chair of Administration, CRC. They've been working in Columbus's immigrant community for years, and I want to thank her for your leadership. Councilmember Paley, is there any comments you'd like to add at this time?
Just want to thank Director Bell and Guadalupe Velasquez for answering the call. Now and in the past, that makes Columbus the best place to live, work, raise a family, and be global. Yes, I got it right, Ms. Velasquez. Thank you.
Any other questions or comments from my colleagues? If not, I move for passage.
Second. Clerk, call the roll.
Hardin, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
Resolution adopted, and I just want to thank Councilmember Hardin for helping us shape our voice around this important issue, and appreciate his work, concern, consideration, and making sure that we're on the record. Thank you.
Thank you. That is all we have in this committee. Thank you.
Thank you, Councilmember Hardin. Councilmember Klein.
I do have one resolution, Council President Ginther. It's 267X2015. And I'd like to invite Dr. Wallace Cameron Giffen, as well as I think his wife may be here, if she wants to come forward, any other family members. This is to thank Dr. Giffen for the outstanding public service he has given over the course of his career to the city of Columbus. The resolution outlines what I believe to be a pretty impressive and storied academic career, and he's served as the chairman and on the Sewer and Water Advisory Board for over a decade. And that, I think, probably the more important part of that is over this decade, the two Ohio EPA consent decrees that you have led Columbus through. So I'd like to move to amend and submit to the clerk.
Hardin, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
And then move for passage.
Second.
Hardin, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
Doctor, thank you for your service. The floor is yours.
Thank you. It's been an honor to serve with such capable, professional people as you have here in utilities and the city administration. It's been a joy.
Well, thank you. Mr. Dorian, I know that you've worked closely with the good doctor.
Thank you, Chairman Klein and all council members. Yes, I've had the privilege of running alongside, learning from Mr. Giffen at the Solid Waste the Sewer and Water Advisory Board over several past years now. So I simply say a very, very sincere thank you, Mr. Giffen. You've taught us all a great deal, and I want you to know I appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Dorian. I do have a resolution for you and your family just to honor your service, and we're grateful for all the work that you've done with our terrific Department of Public Utilities staff. Director Davies, do you want to say anything?
I just want to say thank you, and I think we sold him a little short. I started in 1999, and I believe he was the chair then, so he has really been, outside of Auditor Dorian, probably the most instrumental person in helping us set a course for the department, and he's been just a fantastic public servant for us. Can't thank him enough.
And then when I became the chair of public utilities and how important the Sewer and Water Advisory Board is in shaping what we can do from an infrastructure standpoint and being in compliance with the Ohio EPA, I know that your voice and your steady leadership has put the city on course not only for the thousands, tens of thousands of jobs that have come along with the infrastructure improvements, but also the water quality and the quality of life for our environment that your leadership has guided us to. So we're grateful not only for previous generations, but future generations that will come and reap the benefit of the work that you've done. Thank you, sir.
That's all I have.
Thank you, Councilmember Klein. Councilmember Page? Councilmember Paley?
Yes, President Ginther, I do have one resolution. And if the Ebner family can come forward, I have resolution 0260X 2015, to honor and recognize and celebrate the life of Mr. Murray Ebner and extend our sincere condolences to his family and friends on the occasion of his passing on November 8th, 2015. Normally, I don't read my resolutions, but in this one, I'm going to, because it's very important that we not forget. Mr. Ebner was an important man in our community and deserves the recognition and the honor. So I'm going to read the resolution. Whereas Mr. Ebner was born September 20th, 1928 in Poland, and Mr. Ebner was the sole survivor of his family. He survived 4 years of Nazi enslavement by working in four different subcamps of Auschwitz from ages 13 to 17, and in the spring of 1945, he was forced on a death march out of Birkenau. After hiding in a barn, he was able to escape the Nazis along with three others from a group of about 150. In 1947, Mr. Ebner immigrated to the United States, where he would eventually live with distant relatives in Springfield, Ohio. Mr. Ebner was later drafted into the U.S. Army for the Korean conflict, where he served for 2 years in Germany, protecting the Germans from the Russian military. He later began Ebner Properties as a real estate management and development company in 1970. He devoted much of his time to his family and many philanthropic endeavors, where he has received many awards and accolades, some of which include serving two terms as president of Congregation of Good Osakim, president, vice president, and treasurer of the Wexner Heritage Village, on the boards of Columbus Torah Academy, ADL Regional Board, Columbus Jewish Historical Society, and the CMHA Ad Hoc Committee, member of Congregation Torah Emet, Congregation Beth Jacob, and Congregation Ahavas Shalom. He developed an Emmy Award-winning documentary, A Survivor's Journey, and wrote a biography, Chosen for Reasons Unknown, A Holocaust Survivor's Journey. Murray felt it was his responsibility to bear witness. This is why he believes that God saved him. Murray spoke to thousands of high school students throughout Central Ohio throughout that past couple of decades, and he was always positive, smiling, and endearing, and he will truly be missed. No one truly comprehends the loss that we feel or the sadness we are enduring, but we pray that his memories will forever and always be with you. He was a champion, a hero, a legend, who made this world a better place. Now, therefore, be it resolved by the Council of the City of Columbus that this council does hereby recognize, honor, and celebrate the long and fulfilling life of Mr. Murray Ebner and extend our sincere condolences to his family and friends on the occasion of his passing.
Thank you very much, Councilman Paley. I appreciate that very much. And also want to thank the entire council body. It's very humbling for all of us to stand here today. We lost our father and husband on November 8th, and this is a very difficult time for us. And we learned a lot from him and how much he gave back to Columbus and how much he loved Columbus. And he felt very endeared to Columbus. Columbus was very good to my father. My father was a developer, and he took a lot of pride in developing Columbus. He developed many hundreds of apartments, and I stood in this chamber with him as a teenager many, many times in various zonings. So this council chamber was very meaningful, and it's interesting how we're here today and on his behalf, and here he built so much of his life here in this chamber. And then aside from that, he also spent a lot of time here, many times coming for the Mayor's Remembrance Council. He spoke here, lit candles here. So again, this chamber was very meaningful to my father in so many ways. And I'm so deeply humbled to be here on behalf of our family, my wife Nicole, my daughter Sabrina, my sister Lisa, my mother Sylvia Ebner, and my sister Cindy, now Judge, Cindy Ebner. So we're very, very humbled to be here. And I think of all the things my father built as a developer, one of the things he was probably most proud of is the thing he built in 2004, a building at 1070 College Avenue, in order to give a home to all the Holocaust survivors. He built a museum that we all invite you to visit at 1070 College Avenue, and certainly feel free to read his book. I think you would find it very interesting and moving, his book, Chosen for Reasons Unknown. Again, thank you. We are very moved and very honored, and we thank you deeply.
I have read the book. It is very interesting. If there are no further comments, I move for passage.
Hardin, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
Thank you.
That's all I have this evening, President Ginther.
Thank you, Councilmember Paley. Councilmember Ryan? Well, I have one special announcement and a special recognition and thank you to one of our colleagues. Tomorrow afternoon, the Association of Fundraising Professionals Central Ohio Chapter will be hosting their 2015 National Philanthropy Day at the Downtown Renaissance Columbus. Executive Vice President of the Columbus Foundation, Lisa Cordes, we have the honor to present Councilwoman Fran Ryan with the award for 2015 Outstanding Volunteer Fundraiser. Councilmember Ryan, you've dedicated your life and career to the people of Columbus in Central Ohio, and we thank you for all the different ways that you continue to serve and lift up the people in our community and make our city wonderful. So, I'm embarrassing her because she's not expecting this, but I wanted to recognize Councilwoman Ryan and be the first to congratulate you for an award you'll be given tomorrow, and congratulate you on all of your great work and the service you're doing for your city here as well. So thank you and congratulations. Any announcements from our elected officials? City Auditor? City Attorney? I do believe that we have one request for the following ordinance to be removed from the consent action portion of the agenda in the Administration Committee, 2619-2015. Are there any other requests from members of council for the removal of an ordinance or resolution from the consent action portion of the agenda? Seeing none, may we now have a motion to waive reading of the titles of 30-day legislation by the city clerk. Clerk, call the roll.
Hardin, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
Thank you. Will the clerk now read into the record the ordinance numbers of 30-day legislation on tonight's agenda for first reading?
Public Service and Transportation Committee, Ordinance 2917-2015. Public Utilities Committee, Ordinances 2486, 2697, 2737, 2742, 2745, 2767, 2772-2015. Development Committee, Ordinances 2901, 2907, 2908, 2015, Recreation and Parks Committee, Ordinance 2802-2015. Administration Committee, Ordinance 2871-2015. Rules and Reference Committee, Ordinances 2635 and 3009-2015.
Following ordinances appear on our agenda as consent actions. Will the clerk now read the ordinance numbers of each into the record?
Finance Committee, Ordinances 2510, 2718, 2724, 2725, 2738, 2829, 2831, and 2838-2015. Health and Human Services Committee, Ordinances 2645, 2657, 2709, 2761, 2766, 2844, 2845, 2846, 2847, 2848, and 2851-2015. Public Service and Transportation Committee, Resolutions 239X, 254X, 257X, 258X-2015, and ordinances 2666, 2723, 2743, 2811, 2815, 2832, 2864, 2866, 2868, 2913, 2932-2015, Public Safety Committee, ordinances 2660, 2695, 2728, 2729, 2731, 2792, 2793, 2796, 2828, 2830, and 2840-2015. Public Utilities Committee, ordinances 2302, 2483, 2610, 2614, 2621, 2627, 2629, 2633, 2639, 2642, 2670, 2672, 2679, 2684, 2690, 2693, 2706, 2712, and 2719-2015. Development Committee, ordinances 2689, 2720, 2721, 2722, 2732, 2735, 2736, 2753, 2754, 2755, 2756, 2762, 2765, 2800, 2801, 2820, 2821, 2822, 2849, 2850, 2852, 2896, 2899, and 2903-2015. Recreation and Parks Committee, ordinances 2647, 2659, 2664, 2665, 2682, 2806, and 2904-2015. Administration Committee, ordinances 1741, 2398, 2741, 2751, 2757, 2774, 2794-2015. Judiciary and Court Administration Committee, ordinance 2685, 2703, 2716, 2717, 2768, 2863, and 2865-2015. Environment Committee, ordinance 2686, 2797, and 2914-2015. Technology Committee, ordinances 2532, 2588, 2609, 2680, 2710, 2714, 2785, and 2839-2015. Appointments from the Mayor's Office, numbered A0184 and A0185-2015.
Thank you. We have one speaker on the consent agenda this evening, Mr. Nathaniel George Wilkins. Mr. Wilkins, welcome to Council Chambers. You have signed up to speak on 2820-2015 in the Development Committee on the Consent Agenda. If you chair your name, address, any organizations you represent, sir, you have 3 minutes to speak in support of the ordinance.
Mr. Lieutenant George Wilkins, 1612 Arlington Avenue, the chairman of solely vacant and abandoned property in North Linden area. I just want to know what's going to happen with 1525 East of Weber Road. Would the property be used for? That's what I would like to know. Thank you for your time.
Thank you, Mr. Wilkins. Any questions or comments for Mr. Wilkins? Director Shoney, any additional information you have on 2820-2015?
Thank you, President Ginther, members of council. That property will be rehabbed for a rental property.
Thank you, Director. Any other questions, comments, discussion regarding the consent agenda? Seeing none, may I have a motion for approval of these items designated as consent actions? Is there a second? Clerk, call the roll.
Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
Consent agenda carries. We will now proceed with the second reading of 30-day tabled and emergency legislation. The first committee is the Finance Committee. Councilmember Klein will propose legislation from that committee this evening. Councilmember Klein.
Thank you, Council President. 2812-2015 to authorize and direct the Finance Management Director enter into three UTC contracts for the option to purchase aftermarket auto parts with Genuine Parts Company, Napa Auto Parts, Automotive Distributors, and Skinner Diesel Services to waive the competitive bidding provisions of the Columbus City Code. To authorize the expenditure of $3 to establish the contract from the general fund and to declare an emergency. Could you possibly opine on the waiving competitive bidding provisions, Deputy Director?
Yes, Councilmember Klein. As you may know, the city code allows a single bid award. This is a multiple bid award. This is a product that we're putting into the Venemaya catalog. That's the Amazon.com type procurement that the city purchasing department or division has been promoting. This will allow divisions to continue to compete for the very best product at the very best price with the three most highly ranked offers.
Any
catalog-based purchases.
Okay. Any questions or comments for Deputy Director Bush? Move for passage.
Second. Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
2853-2015, to authorize and direct the city auditor to provide for the transfer of $4,358,220 within the general fund to transfer appropriations between objects in certain non-general fund departments and divisions and declare an emergency. Sir.
Sure. Councilmember Klein, this is an ordinance that reconciles primarily the general fund, but four other funds as well. To reflect the third quarter financial review. In other words, surpluses in some departments and divisions being put into other areas where there were projected deficits. This aligns the budget so that the programs can continue through the balance of the year.
Any questions or comments? I move for passage.
Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
2887-2015, I request the table indefinitely pending a public hearing.
Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
288-2015, request the table indefinitely, pending public hearing.
Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
2889-2015, request the table indefinitely, pending public hearing.
Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
That's all. Thank you.
Thank you, Councilmember Klein. Our next committee is the Health and Human Services Committee. Councilmember Ryan will be proposing legislation from that committee this evening.
In the Health and Human Services Committee, we have ordinance number 2669-2015 to authorize and direct the Board of Health to accept funds from the United Health Foundation in the amount of $1,700,000 to support the implementation of the CelebrateOne Community Connector Corps project and to authorize the appropriation of $1,700,000 to the city's private grants fund and to declare an emergency. Are there any questions or comments? I move for passage.
Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
Ordinance number 2739-2015 to authorize and direct the Board of Health to accept a grant from U.S. Department of Health and Human Services for the Healthy Start Grant Program in the amount of $1,080,000 to authorize the appropriation of the $1,080,000 from the unappropriated balance of the Health Department Grants Fund and to declare an emergency. Are there any questions or comments? I move for passage.
Second. Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
We have ordinance number 2746-2015 to authorize and direct the Board of Health to enter into various contracts for the Healthy Start Grant Program to authorize expenditure of $338,250 from the Health Department Grants Fund to waive the provisions of the Columbus City Codes for competitive bidding and to declare an emergency. Are there any questions? If not, I move for passage.
Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
I'd like to congratulate the Health Department for this and your work with the entire program. That's great. Thank you. May I move on to the Environment Committee? Okay. Thank you, Council President Ginther. We have the ordinance number 2740-2015 to amend the 2015 capital improvements budget to authorize the city auditor to transfer cash and appropriation within the refuse bonds fund and to waive the competitive bidding provisions of Columbus City Code to authorize the finance and management director to enter into the contract for the purchase of 6 rear loader refuse trucks with compressed natural gas, CNG, from Columbus Peterbilt and to establish funding for Division of Refuse Collection personnel to inspect the vehicles during the manufacturing to authorize the expenditure of $1,314,580 within the refuse bond fund and declare an emergency. Are there any questions? If not, I move for passage.
Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
And that's all I have for environmental. President Ginther, may I go on to Technology Committee?
Please.
Ordinance number 2673-2015 to amend the 2015 capital improvement budget to authorize the appropriation of funds and transfer of appropriation and cash between projects to authorize the Director of Department of Finance and Management on behalf of the Department of Technology to establish multiple purchase orders with vendors KLA Laboratories, Inc. and Network Dynamics, Inc. from existing universal term contracts for the purchase of various hardware equipment, wiring, installation, and services to authorize expenditure of $1,470,440.74 from the Department of Technology Information Services Division Capital Improvement Bond Fund and to declare an emergency. Are there any questions or comments? If not, I move for passage.
Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
Ordinance number 2784-2015 to appropriate the $1,282,624.50 with a special income tax fund to authorize the Director of Finance and Management on behalf of the Department of Technology to establish a contract purchase order for the second year of three-year term agreement for Microsoft Enterprise software licensing from Dell Marketing LP from a state term schedule to authorize the modification to the contract agreement with Dell Marketing LP for Microsoft Enterprise software licensing for the first year true up and to authorize the expenditure of $1,282,624.50 or so much thereof as may be necessary from the special income tax fund for the Department of Technology and to declare an emergency. Are there any questions? If not, I move for passage.
Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
Ordinance number 2894-2015 to authorize the Finance and Management Director to enter into a contract for the option to purchase Cisco Network Engineering Services with Network Dynamics, Inc. and to authorize expenditure of $1 to establish this contract from the General Fund to waive the competitive bidding provisions of the Columbus City Code Chapter 329 and to declare an emergency. Are there any questions, comments? I move for passage.
Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
Thank you, Council President Ginther. That is all I have tonight.
Thank you, Councilmember Ryan. Our next committee is the Public Service and Transportation Committee. Councilmember Harden chairs that committee. Mr. Chairman, the floor is yours.
Thank you, President. Thank you, President Ginther. This evening in Public Service and Transportation Committee, we have Ordinance 0301-2015 to establish an underground utilities district to be identified as the King Lincoln Underground Utilities District. If there are no questions or comment, I move for passage.
Second.
Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
Next, I have 0305-2015 to establish an underground utilities district to be identified as the downtown underground utility district. And I'll just quickly, if it's all right, Director, just to give for the next two, all four of these are similar pieces of legislation, but just to quickly to give a high level of what we're talking about here.
Yes, Chairman Harden, President Ginther, members of council, these pieces of legislation are to create underground utility districts in several corridors throughout the city. The city's already invested a significant amount of dollars undergrounding utilities in this area, and it's just to protect that investment so if future utilities come in that they cannot put their hardware above head, it has to go underground and be buried.
Thank you, Director. Move for passage.
Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
Next, 0306-2015 to establish a utility corridor district to be identified as the Morris Road Utility Corridor District. If there are no questions or comments, I move for passage.
Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
And 0307-2015 to establish an underground utilities district to be identified as the Parsons Livingston Avenue Underground Utility District. If there are no questions or comments, I move for passage.
Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
And lastly, I have 2855 to authorize the public service director to enter into contract with 3SG Plus Corporation relative to the Warrior Watch Management Application 2.0 project to authorize the expenditure of up to $100,000 from the Street Construction Maintenance and Repair Fund and to pay for this project and declare an emergency. I wanted to highlight this piece of legislation on a cold day like today to remind everyone that winter is coming and our winter warriors have been making their preparations throughout the summer. Very simply, this ordinance adds some back office functionality to the Warrior Watch application. More importantly, I'd like residents to be aware when the snow covers our streets that you can go to warriorwatch.columbus.gov to see which streets have been treated in the past 72 hours. If there are no questions or comments, I move for passage.
Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
Thank you, President Ginther. That's all we have in public service and transportation this evening.
Thank you, Councilmember Klein. Our next committee is the Public Safety Committee. Councilmember Klein chairs that committee. Mr. Chairman, the floor is yours.
Thank you, Council President. First piece is 2708-2015 to amend the 2015 capital improvement budget to authorize the city auditor to transfer funds between projects within the Department of Public Safety's bond fund, to authorize the Director of Public Safety on behalf of the Division of Support Services to enter into a contract with Intergraph Corporation for the CAD system upgrade in accordance with the sole source procurement provisions of the Columbus City Code, to authorize the Director of the Department of Finance to issue a purchase order for the purchase of computer servers and accessories for the CAD system with OnX Enterprise Solutions, to authorize the expenditure of $1,166,228 from the Public Safety's Capital Bond Fund and declare an emergency. Director speaks.
Thank you, Chairman Klein, President Ginther, members of Council. The City of Columbus receives approximately 900,000 911 calls per year. The CAD system, which stands for Computer Aided Dispatching, is the computer system that helps us manage those 900,000 calls. The system was put in 2010, and this is simply an upgrade to that system, as the old software will no longer be supported by the vendor as of 2016. In addition to the software, this contract will also purchase 9 servers to aid in our dispatching.
Any questions or comments from my colleagues? Seeing none, I move for passage.
Second. Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
2715-2015 to amend the 2015 capital improvement budget to authorize the appropriation and transfer of $495,580 within the General Permanent Improvement Fund, to authorize the appropriation within the Special Income Tax Fund, to authorize and direct the Director of Public Safety enter into a contract with Morpho Track Inc. to upgrade the automated fingerprint identification system for the Division of Police in accordance with the sole source procurement provisions of the Columbus City Code, to authorize the expenditure of $991,703 from the General Permanent Improvement Fund and the Special Income Tax Fund, and to declare an emergency.
Sir. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Similar to the last resolution, this is also a very old computer system. AFIS, which is our fingerprint system, is over 10 years old. There are tens of thousands of fingerprints in this system that we've accumulated over the last decade. This contract simply will upgrade the software. And in addition, what is unique, we have a very strong and wonderful partnership with Franklin County. The Franklin County Commissioners are, for the first time, agreeing to share in the cost as we share this fingerprint system with not only the Sheriff's Office, the county, but other local law enforcement entities, as well as the state of Ohio.
Thank you, Director. Any questions or comments? I move for passage.
Second. Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
Moving on to public utilities. 2636-2015 to authorize the Director of Public Utilities to enter into professional engineering agreement with Chester's Engineers for the Black Lick Creek Main Trunk Sewer LDSA project to authorize the appropriation and transfer of $1,097,054.36 from the Sanitary Sewer Reserve Fund to the Sanitary Sewer General Obligation Bond Fund and to authorize the expenditure of $1,097,054.36 from the Sanitary Sewer General Obligation Bond Fund and to amend the 2015 Capital Improvements Budget. Director Davies.
Chairman Klein, President Ginther, members of council, this is one of our larger sewers. It's actually almost 22 miles long, runs on the east side of the city, and as part of our consent orders, we are required to inspect them periodically, and what we're looking for is the structural integrity. We'll televise the lines, replace manholes, all that kind of stuff, and this first look at it is to determine what additional work will be necessary.
Thank you. Any questions or comments? I move for passage.
Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
2640-2015, to authorize the Finance and Management Director to establish blanket purchase orders with various vendors for water meters and appurtenances based on existing universal term contracts for the Division of Water and to authorize the expenditure up to $1.25 million within the Water Works Enlargement Voted Bond Fund and to declare an emergency. Any questions or comments? I move for passage.
Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
2649-2015, to authorize the Director of Public Utilities to execute a construction contract with Beeler Excavating for the East Deschler Avenue Area Waterline Improvement Project, to authorize the appropriation and transfer of $2,634,735.38 from the Water System Reserve Fund to the Water Supply Revolving Loan Account Fund, to authorize the appropriation and expenditure of $2,634,735.38 within the Water Supply or Revolving Loan Account Fund for the Division of Water and to declare an emergency. Any questions or comments about this waterline improvement? I move for passage.
Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
2667-2015, to authorize the Director of Public Utilities to enter into a planned contract modification with Black & Veatch Corporation Professional Construction Management Services for the OSIS Augmentation and Relief Sewer Phase 1 and 2 project for the Division of Sewage and Drainage to authorize the to authorize the appropriation and transfer of $5,432,991 from the Sanitary Sewer Reserve Fund to the Sanitary Sewer General Obligation Bond Fund and to authorize the expenditure for up to $5,432,991 from the Sanitary Sewer General Obligation Bond Fund. Director Davies.
Chairman Klein, President Ginther, members of council, this is the Orse Tunnel that has been going on for several years, and this is a planned modification. It's a $360 million project, so because of those large numbers, we try to break up the payments in an annual basis rather than paying all up front, and this is what that is.
Any questions or comments for this planned modification? I move for passage.
Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
2668-2015, to authorize the Director of Public Utilities to modify a professional engineering services agreement with Stantec Consulting Services, Inc. for the Division of Sewage and Drainage for the Big Walnut Trunk Extension Phase 2 project, to authorize the appropriation and transfer of $1,071,635.19 from the Sanitary Sewer Reserve Fund to the Sanitary Sewer General Obligation Bond Fund and to authorize the expenditure of up to $1,071,635.19 from the Sanitary Sewer General Obligation Bond Fund. Any questions or comments? I move for passage.
Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
2692-2015. To authorize the Director of Public Utilities to negotiate and enter into a contract for purchase power to waive provisions of the Columbus City Code relating to awarding of contracts through the request for proposal process, to authorize the expenditure of $1 from the Electricity Operating Fund and to declare an emergency. Director.
Chairman Klein, President Ginther, we've done this several times in the past, and what we are asking for is your permission to put an RFP out to get solicitation for purchase power costs. We've been very successful the last 4 years in doing this, and if successful, we will put the RFP out, and that way when we get the prices, since they are so volatile, we can lock in immediately with the lowest provider without having to come back to council.
Any questions or comments for Director Davies? Seeing none, I move for passage.
Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
2707-2015, to authorize the Director of Public Utilities to enter into a plan modification of the Professional Engineering Services Agreement with MWH Americas for the Hap Crimean Water Plant, UV disinfection project for the Division of Water and to authorize an expenditure of up to $1,392,500 from the Waterworks Enlargement Voted Bonds Fund. Any questions or comments about this disinfection project? I move for passage.
Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
Moving on to development. In development, 261X2015 to approve the petition articles of incorporation and initial plan for the creation and governance of the Columbus Regional Energy Special Improvement District and Energy Special Improvement District under Ohio Revised Code Chapter 1710 and to declare an emergency. Director Shoney.
Chairman Klein, President Ginther, members of council, this is the first opportunity that the city has had to put in place what is commonly called an ECID or an energy CID. It's not a special improvement district in the traditional sense that we think of a district where all members of the district pay into a common fund and it's used for things like we see in downtown with safety patrol and things of that nature. This is actually a financing mechanism whereby a building owner puts a special assessment on their property to pay for energy efficiency improvements to their building. So this is actually for the PNC Plaza building on Broad Street. The owners of that building are going to put a special assessment on their property that then can be used to go out and get financing for energy efficiency improvements, things like new lighting, better windows, those kinds of opportunities. What this allows is the property owner to go out and get very attractive financing for that project and use this this special assessment, which operates like a special tax on the building and that building alone, to pay off the debt to accomplish those energy improvements. This happens at no risk to the city. The city has no financial obligations under this. We simply serve as a pass-through. I would like to congratulate our friends at the Finance Authority on accomplishing this. This is another tool for us to improve our city, and I want to thank Jean Carter Ryan and her team at the Finance Authority for putting this in place with us.
So what's the city's role here?
The city really is as a pass-through and an enabler to the Finance Authority. The city does not have any financial risk. It really is to provide the institutional mechanism through which the Finance Authority can put this in place.
And that's all based on the Ohio Revised Code, that the city is required, if the CID is passed, that the city plays this role per the code, but there's no financial interest in the city.
That's absolutely correct.
Okay. Any questions or comments? I move for passage.
Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
2397-2015, I'd first like to remove from the table.
Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
To adopt the 2016 Action Plan budget, which implements the second year of the five-year consolidated plan for the Community Development Block Grant, Home Investment Partnerships, Emergency Solutions Grant, and Housing Opportunities for Persons with AIDS programs. To authorize the filing of the plan application with the U.S. Department of Housing and Urban Development and to declare an emergency. Director Shoney.
Mr. Chairman, President Ginther, members of council, this is the city-wide plan for community development block grant funds. This impacts not only our department, but a variety of departments. This is a requirement by HUD that we file this plan annually. We've been working very hard with our friends at the finance department to put this in place. These funds, as you all know, are critical to moving forward our economic development programs, our social services programs. We fund within development code enforcement. We fund part of our housing program. There's not an element of the city's outreach into our communities that this money does not touch. So this is very important, and we thank you for your consideration.
And there was a public process to this. Could you elaborate on the public process?
Yes, sir. There have been public hearings. You hosted one of those hearings. There is an extensive outreach program. We have worked with community research partners to do some of our outreach and help us draft the plan on this.
Any questions or comments? I move for passage.
Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
2663-2015, to authorize the Director of the Department of Development to enter into contracts with various companies to provide deconstruction, demolition, environmental asbestos testing, asbestos abatement, and post-demolition greening services as part of the Vacant and Abandoned Properties Initiative to waive the competitive bidding provisions of the Columbus City Code for emergency demolitions, to authorize the expenditure of $1.5 million from the Development Taxable Bonds Fund, and to declare an emergency. It's my understanding that the waiving competitive bidding provisions is because of just an emergency structure needs to come down immediately. Obviously, no time to bid because it's not safe, not a safe structure. Any questions or comments? I move for passage.
Second.
Hardin, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
2837-2015, to authorize the Director of Development to execute the First Amendment to the Madison Township Joint Economic Development District contract with the Village of Asheville and Madison Township, and the First Amendment to the Annexation Moratorium Agreement with the Village of Asheville and Madison Township. I'd first like to amend as submitted to the clerk.
Second.
Hardin, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
Director Shoney.
Mr. Chairman, President Ginther, members of council, this is an expansion of the Joint Economic Development District that we have to the south of Rickenbacker. It is outside Franklin County in, and I'm going to draw, Pickaway County, excuse me. This has been a very successful JED so far. We have a couple of operating manufacturing and distribution facilities in that JED. The owners of the property in the JED have identified an old golf course that they wish to purchase and add to the JED and make it developable land and hopefully bring more jobs to the region and to Columbus's residents.
Any questions or comments? I move for passage.
Hardin, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
2877-2015, to amend the Job Creation Tax Credit Agreement with Express LLC, Express Holding LLC, Express Topco LLC, Express Inc., and Express Fashion Operations LLC for the purpose of extending the incentive term by 2 years and to declare an emergency. Last one, Director.
Mr. Chairman, President Ginther, members of council, this is an expansion of an existing incentive that we have with Express. They have been doing very well at their location, and they're actually planning on adding more jobs and doing additional investment at that location. So rather than create a brand new incentive, we have chosen to add a couple of their entities to this that will allow them to bring those entities into this facility and extend the incentive by 2 years.
Thank you. Any questions or comments? I move for passage.
Hardin, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
Now bear with me, Council President, as I move to rules and reference. So the following pieces on rules and reference have to do with rate increases for water and sewer, as well as some changes to some electrical billing for the Department of Electricity. Director Davies, do you want to give an overview before I plow through the legislation?
Sure. Chairman Klein, President Ginther, members of council. Yes, the first piece is based upon a rate study that we had done in the Division of Power to continue our efforts to strengthen that base. What we discovered during that process was that the service we provide to our large customers, which is dedicated power without other folks on that line, we could actually charge more for, as other utilities do. So we are recommending that we increase that by 15%. And then we also realized that we were overcharging our small commercial, which would be churches, schools, small businesses. So we're asking to reduce that by 15%. So with those two changes, the annual revenue that we will generate for the division is approximately $478,000.
So when you say overcharging, it's not overcharging in the sense of the clerical error as much as what the market rate is demanding.
We just mistakenly had that at too high of a rate, and we, you know, those are customers that we want to be more competitive with, so we felt that it was important, and since we could generate these additional dollars, that we would help out small businesses and others in that category.
So the rate will be lowered to a more competitive market rate?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Both ways.
And what about, and we had a public hearing on this, the water and sewer?
Sure. The increases this year that we are recommending Water is 4%, sanitary sewer 3%, stormwater 1%. Total of the bill would be 3.31%. That's roughly $8.58 a quarter. We've talked many times about all the projects that we're working on, $500 million in our water plant expansions and the construction of that upground reservoir and the UV that we talked about tonight, as well as on the sanitary side, the Oars Tunnel, which I mentioned earlier was $360 million, our blueprint Columbus program, which will be kicking off next year, will go on for another 20, 30 years. So we have a lot of capital work to do. We only raised our operating side by roughly 1.3%, so we are holding all the costs that we can as tight as we can. But unfortunately, most of our budget is driven by capital, and we are at a busy time. We still offer the low-income discount, which is 20% on water and sewer commodity charge, eligible if you qualify for federal and state programs. And we also have a senior discount for anyone 60 years or older, and we waive the service charge for that. We put that in bill inserts, have it at senior centers, libraries, try to advertise that as much as possible and encourage anybody to take advantage of that if they're eligible. And if you have any further questions, we discussed a lot of this at the hearing, but I'd be happy to answer any questions.
Thank you, Director Davies. Any questions or comments about these before I go through them? Okay. 2132-2015, to amend Chapter 1163 of the Columbus City Codes to enact new rate class and electricity service rates for the year beginning January 1, 2016, and to repeal the existing sections being amended. I move for passage.
Hart and Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
2698-2015, to amend Chapter 1147 of the Columbus City Codes to enact new sanitary sewer service rates for the year beginning January 1, 2016, and to repeal the existing sections being amended. I move for passage.
Second. Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
2699-2015, to amend various sections of Chapter 1105 of the Columbus City Codes to enact new water rates and revise meter service fees for the year beginning January 1, 2016, and to repeal the existing sections being amended. I move for passage.
Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
2701-2015, to amend Section 114908 of the Columbus City Codes to enact new stormwater fees for the year beginning January 1, 2016, and to repeal the existing section being amended. I move for passage.
Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
2769-2015, to amend existing Section 540.05 of the Columbus City Codes to increase the scope of current convictions by which the license section may deny an application to operate a massage or bath establishment within the City of Columbus. This is different from the, obviously, water rates. This was pursuant to a hearing that Department of Public Safety had in increasing penalties to include the scope of what convictions we will allow for massage parlors based on the hearings we had in human trafficking. And the discovery that there are some crimes that have a tendency to be related to human trafficking that we allow massage parlor owners to have convictions in, but yet we still grant the license. And this is in line in what the director and I, Director Speaks and I, saw as low-hanging fruit to do the city's part in preventing individuals who are massage parlor owners and operators to ensure that if they have a history of anything related to what could be construed as human trafficking, that we don't want women to be put in the situation by being a masseuse at one of those establishments. I think we saw evidence of a recent conviction out of Delaware, Powell, in the Southern District of Ohio, of some individuals that were involved with human trafficking, but operating a massage parlor as a front for human trafficking. Director Speaks, do you want to back clean up on that and clarify anything I said?
Chairman Klein, I would say that even though that case emanated out of Delaware County, that the Columbus Division of Police, as you know, did have a hand in assisting in that case. Most glaringly, human trafficking laws in Ohio are somewhat new, and our city statute was promulgated much prior to that. Yeah. So this catches up, if you will, our city code. No longer can folks who are convicted of human trafficking be able to have a massage business here in the City of Columbus. Thank you for that hearing.
Yeah. Any questions or comments on this issue? I move for passage.
Second. Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
That's all. Council President Ginther.
Thank you, Councilmember Klein. Our next committee is the Recreation and Parks Committee. Councilmember Page chairs that committee. Madam Chair, the floor is yours.
Thank you, President Ginther. This night in Recreation and Parks, we have Ordinance 2589-2015 to authorize and direct the Director of Recreation and Parks to enter into contract with Thomas & Marker Construction Company for the Gregory S. LaShucka Event Center Project, to authorize the expenditure of $1,962,000 with a contingency of $196,200 for a total of $2,158,200 from the Recreation and Parks Voted Bond Fund, Recreation and Parks Permanent Improvement Fund, and Public Utilities Water Works Enlargement Bond Fund, to authorize the city auditor to appropriate $288,092.22 to the Recreation and Parks Permanent Improvement Fund, to authorize the city auditor to transfer $70,586.18 within the Recreation and Parks Voted Bond Fund, to amend the 2015 capital improvement budget, and to declare an emergency. I would just like to urge my colleagues to support this ordinance. This will help with the rehab that will be done to the historical building at this location, as well as continue to improve on the recreational amenities that we provide to our residents. So if there are no questions or comments, I move for passage.
Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
Ordinance 2834-2015, to authorize and direct the Director of Recreation and Parks to enter into contract with Roger D. Fields Associates Incorporated for engineering services to add air conditioning to four athletic complexes, to waive competitive bidding provisions of Chapter 329 of the City Codes, to authorize the expenditure of $33,000 with a contingency of $3,000 for a total of $36,000 from the Recreation and Parks Voted Bond Fund, and to declare an emergency. Additionally, I would like to ask my colleagues to support this ordinance, as we want to make sure our residents who are doing recreational activities in our complexes have proper air conditioning, are kept cool. And also, Director Collins, if you could speak briefly as to why we're waiving the competitive bidding provisions.
Chair Page, President Ginther, council members. Yes, this is the firm that did the mechanical engineering on the projects when we did these renovations originally. So they have the start on the project, and this is just installing the air conditioning units, getting the specs done for that. So there's a cost savings and time savings as well.
Thank you, Director. Are there any questions or comments? Seeing none, I move for passage.
Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
In our final ordinance this evening, 2922-2015, to authorize and direct the Director of Recreation and Parks to enter into a primary agreement with Capital South Community Urban Redevelopment Corporation and Ohio Not-for-Profit Corporation for the design and construction of the Scioto Peninsula Garage and Park Project, to authorize the expenditure of $1,600,000 from the Recreation and Parks Bond Fund, to authorize the expenditure of $2,400,000 from the Development Streets and Highways Bond Fund, and to declare an emergency. Director Collins.
Chair Page, Council President Ginther, members of council. Yes, we're very pleased to move forward on this project. This is a great partnership with CDC in regarding the design work for the park that will sit on top of the garage just to the west of the Coastside building. We're very pleased about what this will do for the community from an economic development standpoint, as well as a quality of life improvement. It's great. It's going to be a great site.
Thank you, Director Collins. I would also like to invite Matthew Lutz, the Chief Development Officer and General Counsel for Columbus Downtown Development Corporation and Capital South, to speak briefly about the impact of this project and beginning the work.
Thank you, Councilwoman. We've seen in Columbus that green space is a powerful tool for urban development. There are national examples like Millennium Park and Bryant Park, but right here we have the Columbus Commons and Soda Mile that we've partnered together between CDDC, Capital South, and the city, and we've leveraged hundreds of millions of dollars of private investment. This park just west of Coastside will be a continuation of those of the efforts at the Soda Mile and the Soda Greenways, This will be a world-class urban park that will be the centerpiece for the new peninsula development, connecting all of the elements, connecting COSI, the new Ohio Veterans Memorial and Museum, and the future developments that will be located there. So we're very excited to partner with the city again on this important opportunity.
Thank you. Are there any questions or comments for either the director or Mr. Lutz? Thank you so much. And again, I would just urge my colleagues to support this ordinance. We're continuing with the improvements to our downtown area, and I thank Director Collins and the CDDC for the work that they're doing. If there are no questions or comments, I move for passage.
Hart and Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
Thank you, President Ginther.
Thank you, Councilmember Page. Our next committee is the Judiciary and Court Administration Committee. Councilmember Paley chairs that committee. Madam Chair, the floor is yours.
Thank you, President Ginther. And the Judiciary and Court Administration Committee, this evening we have legislation 2833-2015 to authorize and direct the city attorney to pay the judgment entered in accordance with the jury verdict in favor of the plaintiff in the case of Joseph Hines versus Thomas DeWitt et al. In the United States District Court for the Southern District of Ohio, and to authorize the expenditure of $30,000 from the general fund and to declare an emergency. If there are no questions or comments, I move for passage.
Martin, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
Next, I have ordinance 2872-2015. To authorize the appropriation of $50,000 from the Public Safety Initiative Fund to authorize the city auditor to transfer said funds from the Public Safety Initiative Fund to Municipal Court Specialty Docket Program Fund. I would like to thank my co-sponsor, Councilmember Klein. Do you have any comments, Councilmember Klein?
Thank you, Chair Paley. Again, and your partnership on this, this arose out of the human trafficking hearings that we had here, and how Judge Herbert, again, how can, in requesting Judge Herbert, how can we make your job easier? How can the city weigh in to make a difference in the human trafficking sphere? He said a probation officer that deals specifically with human trafficking victims and women that are arrested through prostitution stings and being picked up on the street that have evidence of human trafficking, which is in the 90% of the women that are involved. The same 90% have opiate addictions, and by providing the specialty docket, which is world-renowned, pretty much internationally renowned, and what Judge Herbert and Judge Vandercar are doing, and soon to be Judge-elect Paley, what she'll be doing, this gives them more bandwidth to be able to address and support these women who are victims of crime. So I thank Chair Paley for her work and diligence. A lot of the work that's been done historically on this council was initiated by Judge-elect Paley, and I feel very good about when she takes the bench carrying the torch of that passion to change these victims' lives from a different perspective from council to the bench. Thank you.
Thank you, Councilmember Klein. Just want to reiterate that from the beginning, the catch court and the other special entity dockets have actually saved the city money from the jail fund, and so this will further, I hope, help us save money and save lives. If there are no other questions or comments, I move for passage.
Second. Hart and Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
Next, I need to go back to page 19 in the Administration Committee. And on ordinance 2619-2015, I move to table until December 7th.
Hart and Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
Thank you. That's all I have this evening, Council President Ginther.
Thank you, Council Member Paley. Anything else to come before council this evening? We do have a couple of non-agenda speakers that will take momentarily. We'll reconvene for zoning as close to 6:30 as we can get there. Nothing else? I'd entertain a motion to adjourn. Clerk, call the roll.
Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
Take non-agenda speakers momentarily. We stand adjourned. Regular meeting number 54 will now come to order. Can I get a motion to dispense with the reading of the journal? Is there a second? Clerk, call the roll.
Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
Any communications and reports received by the city clerk?
No, there are not.
Any first readings of 30-day legislation?
No, there are none.
We will now go to the zoning committee. I chair that committee. All members serve on that committee. This evening in zoning, we have 2819-2015 to grant a variance from the provisions of sections 3356.03C4 permitted uses for the property located at 5265 Gender Road, 43110, to permit a self-storage facility and or limited outside storage in the C4 commercial district and to repeal ordinance number 1220-2005, passed September 12, 2005. The applicant is J. Johnson Investments, LLC, care of Jackson B. Reynolds, the third attorney, Smith & Hale, 37 West Broad Street, Suite 460, Columbus, Ohio, 43215. Proposed use is self-storage facility and or limited outside storage. City Department recommendation is approval. The Greater Southeast Area Commission recommended approval. Any questions or comments regarding this legislation? If not, move for passage. Clerk, call the roll.
Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
Passed. Next is 2843-2015 to grant a variance from the provisions of sections 3333.02 ARLD, apartment residential district uses, 3312.49C, minimum parking spaces required, and 3333.34 A, D, E, and J, home occupation of the Columbus City Codes for the property located at 1233 Mount Vernon Avenue, 43203, to permit 3 800 square foot live work units or commercial tenant spaces with reduced parking in the ARLD apartment district. The applicant is Michael Duffy of McCormick Barron Salazar Development, care of Travis J. Eifert, P.E., E.M.H.T., 5500 New Albany Road, Columbus, Ohio, 43054. Proposed use is 3 live work units or commercial tenant spaces. City Department's recommendation is approval. Near East Area Commission recommended approval. Are there any questions or comments? Discussion? Seeing none, move for passage. Clerk, call the roll.
Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
Passed. Anything else to come before the zoning committee this evening? If not, entertain a motion to adjourn. Clerk, call the roll.
Harden, Klein, Page, Paley, Ryan, President Ginther.
We stand adjourned. Have a good evening.